jump rope. My little sister has a jump rope just like that.
I think I know these guys.
Wing Chun's numeric punching is an excellent way to prepare your muscles for a rigorous workout. Lessons 57 through 82. The elbow blocking system. In the Wing Chun system, learning to watch and block the elbow is an important skill in attacking and defense. Rather than blocking the fist, which the eye does not follow well when close, train to block the elbow. From a cocked position, the elbow will cover half the distance of the hand in a punch. Since it is slower than the fist, it is easier to find and control. An opponent's balance and focus can be disrupted by blocking at the elbow. This jams his technique and forces him to withdraw the attacking arm. Stopping wide arcing punches such as a hook follows the same principle. Here, Master Cheung demonstrates progressive blocks inward. The key behind progressive blocking is that once the lead hand makes contact, you can glide along your own arm to reach the elbow. Watch and see how Master Cheung glides his left arm along to locate the elbow. To develop these blocking reflexes demands constant chi sao practice and training to focus on the elbow during a technique. Single arm chi sao review. On tape one, we covered this Wing Chun technique and other basic chi sao exercises, which we will now review. This is the basic starting position for parallel arm chi sao. It is important to master the one-arm chi sao exercises on both sides, right and left, before attempting two-handed chi sao. Be aware that you can be hit at any time during this exercise whenever you present an opening. Your partner will instinctively feel your shift in intentions and strike to the unguarded zone. Never apply too much downward pressure from a fok sao. Nor should you apply too much outward pressure from ton sao. Wing Chun crossed arm chi sao exercise develops your touch reflexes and timing with both practitioners operating from the outside gate. On tape one, we showed you that there are several continuing techniques that develop from this crossed arm chi sao position. Each technique must be thoroughly mastered before going on to the next step. This simple yet effective Wing Chun training exercise is one of the keys in learning to process your blocks and strikes in close quarters with speed and fluidity. Notice Master Cheung's Bong Sao hand. It is firm and solidly deflects the oncoming blow. If you perform this exercise incorrectly, you produce a static and ineffective rhythm. We pointed out on tape one the proper way to parry during this sequence. Can you now spot the errors? The correct flow in this exercise will enable you to effectively apply the Wing Chun basic and advanced moves. Observe the combined Wing Chun techniques of elbow blocking and Chi Sao fluidity in the following techniques. Touch sensitivity and technique combine to give the Wing Chun practitioner the edge in close quarters, hand-to-hand combat. Two-arm Chi Sao. Starting two-arm Chi Sao requires control of both hands to perform separate functions. Here, Master Cheung demonstrates the basic hand positions and moves for you to master in order to begin Chi Sao. Let's study them in slow motion. Strike. Tan Sao. Bong Sao. Block. Straight punch. Fok Sao. Tan Sao, and repeat the sequence again. Learn each hand position by name and call it out as Master Cheung performs them. Palm strike. Tan Sao. Bong Sao. Block. Straight punch. Fok Sao. Tan Sao. Now we are ready to begin the two-man rotation sequence. Master Cheung points out several errors you should learn and avoid in this exercise. The tansao should be straight. The fuxao should not exert forward pressure. With the tansao hand too low, you are left open to a strike. The hand should be at an angle and able to deflect an incoming punch. Now we are ready to begin. Study the form closely and aim to produce a smooth flowing action. Having learned the basic rotation exercise, we move now to a chi sao blocking and striking exercise using the hand positions you learned earlier. Each hand must maintain its appointed position while the other performs its specific task. You should aim for total control of each hand and its movements. The sense of awareness you develop should be touch sensitive and not reliant on sight. Chi Sao is not an easy exercise to master, and we recommend you take time to study the basics of each movement. Lessons 86 through 94. The five stages of combat. Combat in Wing Chun starts in the pre-contact stage. Here, a Wing Chun practitioner is able to face his opponent from any direction while maintaining the central line. If the opponent shifts in any direction, the central line can be safely held from a neutral stance. Stage two is contact with the opponent. Contact can occur on the outside, or inside of the opponent's lead hand, and from either a parallel or cross-legged stance. You should be able to cover a moving and shifting opponent regardless of direction, so that any closing or contact technique can be used. From contact to exchange is stage three. Upon contact, the Wing Chun principles you have learned earlier come into play. Pursuit is stage four of combat. This involves entry methods used to close the gap. Here again, we see pursuit. The last stage, which is not shown, is retreat. The butterfly swords, or Bát Zhǎn, originated from the Shaolin Temple and were used by monks and nuns in their travels. The eight-slash sword form seen here contains techniques designed to strike the wrists, elbow, knees, and ankle. This form will be repeated for you once at normal speed and again in slow motion. Now study the form in slow motion. The stepping, kicking, and hand techniques are basically those that you have studied on tape one. Began Kung Fu as a student of the Wing Chun system. He was introduced to the art by William Cheung. The two were close friends and students under Yip Man. Lee's use of Wing Chun empty hand techniques and weapons such as the dragon pole were quite frequent in his films. A Wing Chun practitioner could easily spot their use. Versus staff. Here, Master Cheung and assistant demonstrate the parry slash methods of the butterfly swords against the dragon pole. Each Wing Chun technique is viewed clearly, but we do advise that you exercise care when practicing with a partner. Notice the disarming slashes to the hand as the sword moves in progressively for the final cut. Lessons 95 through 110. Entry on lead leg kick. Wing Chun entry methods applied against other systems is not difficult once you understand certain principles. Moving in is a matter of keeping covered with the option to kick or strike as you close. From a parallel stance, always step to the outside of the opponent's lead leg. Stopping the knee and elbow operate on the same principle during entry. Both keep you from being hit as you close. Entry on a boxer. In the following examples, in closing on a boxer, Master Cheung goes for the elbow every time. Study the techniques closely and try to understand them from what you have learned about stepping, the elbow system, and Chisao. Note where Master Cheung steps. Notice that from a parallel leg stance, even though Master Cheung blocks inside the opponent's guard, he is stepping outside the opponent's lead leg. This gives him superior balance and leverage. In this technique, Master Cheung times his entry to move in on the opponent's backward shuffle. Notice how blocking at the elbow causes the opponent to lose his balance on this hook punch. Entry on a kickboxer. Here, Master Cheung demonstrates the use of a lead leg to block a low kick. Always follow up with a strike. This is a Wing Chun counter to a high kick. With a spinning back fist, maintain your guard and strike to the exposed back and head. Note footwork. With a spin kick, change steps to keep your distance. Close and counter. Entry on a karate stylist. A reverse punch is very easy for a Wing Chun practitioner to see. It is telegraphed, and the intentions are read miles ahead of the strike. Successfully blocking a kick can be done if you once again treat the knee as you do the elbow. Stopping it stops the blow. A hook kick is countered similar to the spin kick we saw before. Lessons 111 through 116. Railroad Station Fight Reprise.
I'm sure you recognize our friends from the railroad station. They've come back to recreate the fight you saw earlier. We will show you the move you can make in a situation such as this.
Master Cheung parries and strikes with the same hand as he finishes with a follow-up technique. A close-up of the blocking technique used. There are several Wing Chun principles in operation here. Can you identify them? Five stages of combat, entry techniques, blocking at the elbow. What can you identify? In the Wing Chun system, there are three forms. Silom Tao, you learned on tape one. Chum Kim form is the second. It teaches you proper hand and footwork coordination. The Tao of Wing Chun. The aim behind the practice of Wing Chun is to develop physical, mental, and spiritual awareness. These elements transcend you to a higher level of life. Self-awareness, self-respect, and a duty to serve should be the goal of every martial artist. Meditate on these principles and make peace through your studies of Kung Fu, a way of life.